The workday starts early on the Hornstra Dairy Farm. Well before sunrise, the farm is alive with the movement of animals, people, and vehicles. But if the farm is the beehive of activity, the delivery drivers are the busiest of its worker bees. Mike Onis has been driving a Hornstra delivery truck for a decade, making somewhere between 120 to 150 stops each day on his routes. On this day, we catch up with him in Duxbury. It's 10 a.m., and he is more than halfway done with his deliveries, having arrived at the farm at 3:30 in the morning.
I don't have to go to the gym.
That's a fringe benefit of
exactly.
Working for Hornstra.
Yeah.
And it was like that before the pandemic hit.
I actually told my boss, if this hits us, we might get a little busy. And it ended up being the understatement of the year.
With the state under a stay-at-home advisory and some grocery stores running low on supplies, the phone started ringing. Hornstra was already serving 3,500 customers. They added another 650 almost immediately, and the wait list grew to 700. Farm employee Mary Reimer.
During the heat of it, so about mid-April, we were making about 4,100 deliveries in 1 week, and that is about a 25% increase of home delivery compared to last year. If you compared it to a week last year, sales pretty much doubled. So people were ordering a lot more on home delivery.
The farm store initially offered curbside pickup. It's now open and busy, as is the ice cream stand. Every aspect of the operation has been humming.
So we were busier in the office, we were busier in the processing plant. The guys went from processing 3 days a week to sometimes processing 6 days a week, and they were definitely bottling a lot more milk.
11,300 gallons a week through the plant, a combination of their own milk and some they bottle for other farms, more than double the 4,400 gallons per week a year ago. But it's much more than just milk. Hornstra delivers all sorts of dairy products, chicken and meats, prepared foods, bread, and more.
I first came because I could get milk in glass bottles and not have to recycle plastic. Their milk is absolutely superior.
Well, it's fresh milk, no additives, which is really good, and the service is excellent.
The ice cream stops bringing you here, and then the store, they're friendly. The curbside service right after all this started was unique and it was easy to do.
I've been a regular home delivery customer for 20 years, so I'm only here today because I forgot a couple things and ran out of a couple things, and I'm in between errands, and I know they always have a great selection. They're wonderful to buy from, and I like supporting local.
All of our customers have been so thankful. I can't tell you the amount of calls we've gotten in the office about customers telling us that they couldn't leave their homes and that they were worried about leaving their homes, but we were there and we were able to provide them with the product that they needed.
The gratitude extends to those who are still on the wait list, like this woman on Mike's Duxbury route.
I'll be grabbing 84 more customers in Duxbury.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah,
so, slowly but surely.
Yeah, there's
right?
84 in Duxbury alone. So,
wow.
Yeah.
Amazing.
Yeah.
Yeah. You guys are doing a fantastic job, though.
Oh, thank you.
Today's a beautiful day, but it's not always like this.
No, it's you get the rain, you get the really hot weather, wintertime, you get the blizzards. But that's also when they want us bad, too. They're not going to the store.
And in the 105-year history of the farm, they have never missed a delivery, as we learned from fourth-generation farmer John Hornstra on a previous visit.
In 2003, we had a heck of a winter. I remember being a kid and laying underneath milk trucks, putting tire chains on with my dad and my uncle so they could go deliver milk in the blizzard of 78.
It's both a legacy of which they are proud and a sense of duty that extends to their response to the current circumstances.
Being a farm and being able to supply our community with local food where you know where it comes from and be able to help families in need gives us a lot of pride in our job, and I think I can say that for everyone who work here. We do love our job.
Totally gratifying to me. It became a duty, and it's very, very humbling to be able to do this. So it wasn't work anymore, it was a duty.
A duty that doesn't end when the deliveries are finished. Drivers return to the farm to load up their trucks for the next day. And before dawn, the whole process begins again.